The choices you make in high school, they're not that final. You still have time to find your own thing. Our project was about building environmental sensing capabilities for an autonomous vehicle.
So the idea was, after it can see its environment and locate itself, the point is that furthermore, when it's developed, the car can just drive by itself and avoid obstacles. What we did basically, we put the eyes on the car, so it's not blind anymore.
As a kid, I got into programming because my dad is a programmer, and I think that was the first contact I had to computers, really. Then I ended up doing these silly websites with my brother and got into more programming stuff, and that's basically what I did most of my childhood.
In problem solving, the more heads we used, like when we have all of the guys around.
Yeah.
That was the best moments, basically. Everything just went smoothly. In the future, the next group will probably work on the path planning.
Possibly identifying objects around the car that is built on the stuff that we managed to complete. For me, high school was pretty easy. I mean, I didn't get straight A's, but I managed okay without doing much extra effort.
For me, it was okay, I had favorite subjects and I had not so favorite. So those not so favorite subjects are always difficult because you don't have the motivation to study them at all.
But then it was different when coming to the university. I think what caught me most off guard was how complex and deep things really were in math and physics and chemistry.
There were a lot of new subjects for me, for example, programming. I wasn't expecting that much programming from automation and systems engineering. So that took me a little while to cope with it. As a kid, you have this goal here, but in the end, you might end up choosing something related to it. It's not exactly that specific thing. New favorite things comes into your life.